Hello world, you sexy beasts. All right, so before we get started, and it's time to do more with your money. Today is a good day for a good day. So before we get started, Alexa, play. All right, enough said. Alexa, shut up. Okay, let's get right into it. All right, so it's time to do more with your money, right? So, in doing some research, I was able to find out some really, really good stuff as I continue to do my research. Again, I try to keep everybody dialed in with as much information as I can, and this pertains to the digital assets. This pertains to cryptocurrencies, blockchains. This pertains to digital education. I mean, like I said, I'll refer back to the Super Bowl. The Super Bowl was the first venue in the history of Super Bowl histories ever to go digital, all digital. So, I mean, who knows? I mean, in the next couple years, they could accept Dogecoin. And you guys see my last video with that. I explained what Dogecoin is. So just be careful when you buy in. And again, with these stocks, you got to be careful. So again, I'm trying to give you the best tips so where you can do your research, you know, and come up with the best strategy that works for you. My strategy, again, is I would like to get into as many resources as possible. My portfolio, people are going to look at it and be like, that's a clusterfuck. But it doesn't matter. You know why? Because my fucking portfolio. So some people invest in 5 things, 10 things, whatever. I think we'll go through the stocks here in a minute, but I try to get in as many resources. Now, when I say that, I look at every single resource from water, energy, the banking, cryptocurrency, Ethereum, blockchains. I look at every lithium. I'm looking everywhere because everyone's going to be focused on Dogecoin. Everyone's going to be focused on cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, right? Well, what does it take to get this done? It takes mining for units, right? You have to mine for units through technology and software. You have to mine for these units of cryptocurrency. And I mean, it's being used in transactions everywhere. We discussed this before. You know, again, I'll give you a few websites. Check them out. Again, do your research. GypsyBee.com. Everything electronics. Drones, fashion, sports, camping. I mean, you can use cryptocurrency right now. You know what they take? Ethereum, Bitcoin, Litecoin, USD, and Euro. So again, if you haven't heard before, you need a Coinbase account. You do need a Coinbase account. All right. Peddler.com is another one. That's the new offer up. So that's what I do. When I do my research, I'm looking at the how technology has evolved, right? When, I mean, we're millennials, right? I mean, we have our parents, you know, a lot of them are okay with the technology and learning, but we see that it was a struggle, right? So meaning that when I was 4, I wasn't in an iPad. We didn't even have an iPad, right? I'm going to be 36, you know, coming up here in the next week. And through all of my research, I was able to find that now that technology is here. So with Instagram, for example, when Instagram came out, if you look at all the data analysis, look at all the charts, look at everything when it came out, everybody was interested, right? Meaning all the younger generation, everybody was interested. Then we had that big spike because our parents, our grandparents, our relatives want to know what we're doing. And the way they can keep up with us was through Instagram, to look at our pictures, our grandkids, their grandkids, our children, everything. So I'm babbling on, I apologize. But there's a lot more with that. So let's get back into the stocks and basically what's going on with Ethereum and what I was able to find. And I got some good stuff. So real quick, Tesla, you know, Elon, the fucking beast, you know, he has this new vehicle coming out. It's a Roadster. I mean, when this shit pops off, I mean, can you imagine the artificial intelligence that's going to be behind this? Can you imagine the increase for Piedmont Lithium, PLL? You know why? Because they make that special grade SC6. So as the demand goes up, you know, so does the demand for everything else. So I look at resources. Where are the resources at? That's what I follow. That's the way I try to do smart investing. And again, I'll show you everything. You guys will see my stocks. I won't fucking hide it. You guys will see everything, okay? Good vibes only, baby. Good vibes only. We're here to make money, all right? So this is the way I like to see it. Let's get in the fucking stocks. All right, let's go ahead and check some stuff out. And you guys do, again, do your research. The best way and while I get in this too, you know, Robinhood, be careful with Robinhood. And the reason why I say that, it's like rob them hood. Because this is why, though, real shit. Because when you first get in, they get you excited by giving you a free stock, right? You scratch off, you're like, it's like it's the excitement. Oh, I'm gonna scratch it, and you scratch one of them. And you'll see if you have a profile, if you've already been through the process, you'll see that you get a free stock. When you do, you already see, hey, this stock, I'm already at $6. You get fucking excited. Shut the fuck up, don't get excited and sell that shit. The reason why you sell that is because they picked it for you. I don't want it. How do I know this is any good? I haven't done research on it. You can have it back. And you know what? Thank you for the $6. So I appreciate that. So my first recommendation is, if you're going to get Robinhood and they give you that free stock, give that shit right back. Here, no thank you. But thank you for the $6, whatever it is. Second, you know, just be careful. You have to be careful every single time. I have my last video, I explained a little bit more in the depth and detail. But just be careful. Smart investing. So a lot of people are going to go, they see what the way Tesla's going. So they go, the people that have the money can do this. Again, I have a job every day. You know, I mean, fortunately, I work 3 days out of the week, which is wonderful, but I'm blessed enough to have that. And I thank God for every day for that. I get more time with my family. But in doing so, it gives me more time to do research, right? And it gets me excited, because as I'm finding this, I start seeing, okay, well, if somebody had a lot of money, yes, they can invest in Tesla and these other stocks, but how can somebody, you know, do this from the bottom, you know, from the bottom up, you know, building that strong foundation I was talking about in my last video, right? So if we're going to build that strong foundation, then for me, I'm going to try to get in as many natural resources as I possibly can, because how can I lose at that point? I'm in everything. So when I say fashion, so like I said, Christine Andrew, she's, you know, just signed a deal with Kohl's, you know, and Kohl's signed another deal with another entrepreneur. So Kohl's is going to come up, you know. Again, I'm trying to get in as much natural resources as I can, as much as everything as I can, every resource through, I mean, like I said, through the banking, through blockchains, through all these new electric vehicles, right? If you start seeing, all you have to do is open your eyes and pay attention, and you'll start seeing, man, all these cars are cheap. Everyone's going to get excited and want to buy all these cars from these dealerships because they're so cheap. Why? Well, they have to phase them out. They got to get rid of them. So yes, they want you to buy them. That's where you negotiate them. You go, they say, hey, it's $10,000. They make you feel like you're getting a deal. And you go, nah, fuck that. I'll give you $8,000. They're about to phase these out. So you want to take my $8,000 or not? Ride around for a couple years, you're good. Now, only certain models will be phased out as we transition to this whole electric vehicle thing. Again, next video on that. There's a lot to get on that. So let's get into the stocks. But again, if I had $5,000, like my cap, that's my cap. Once I have $5,000 invested, as soon as I got $5,000 invested, again, this is exactly what I'm going to do every single time. I'm going to come up, and I'm just going to just relax, and I'm going to do nothing. Go back to life, society, have fun. Go back to the restaurants being open. Go back to the movies. Go back to, you know, just having fun, right? But guess what? Now I got someone, and not just someone, I got many someone's working for me while I'm working. And this is where it's time to do more with your money. So that's what I'm talking about, right? And so let's just get into the stocks. I'm babbling on, I apologize. Sometimes the fucking ADHD kicks in and I don't shut the fuck up. So it's okay. I'm not gonna get offended. I'm not here, you know, I'm not going to be offended by the comments. It has nothing to do with that. This is, again, educational. It's to show people, hey, you know, Matt's right. Everything is digital. Why is, you know, the Twitter of CEO, You know, I mean, hey, I got in that stock too. I mean, well, let's get into this, okay? We're going to go ahead and get into the stocks. And I'm going to go ahead and show you guys exactly what's going on, all right? So this is going to be when I first started, and I'll show you when I first started. Everything that I'm showing you is going to be through data, research, everything. I challenge you to be come back and be like, hey, you're a dumb fucking, you're wrong, and you wasted 10 minutes of my time. I'll be like, hey, I'll eat that shit. So right now, this is what I'm investing right now. Can you see that? Okay. So I'm investing $2,840, okay? Now, I'm going to go ahead and hit live, right? Live, okay? So live, just so you can see, so the number looks live. Live, okay? Now, for those of you that see red and think red is bad, it's, again, it's no different back to that whole philosophy I said when you get the Robinhood stock and you scratch it, you get the excitement. It's the same thing. You green, you think, oh, green is good. That's what they teach you in fucking school. If you get marked with the fucking red pen, it's bad. No. If you see red, again, do your research. You're fine. You just got to look at your shit. Pay attention. Don't panic. Again, everybody panics, and that's the problem. Okay. So when I first signed up for this, when I first signed up, I put in $500. Okay. 500. Now, when I first signed up, it will tell you right now. I signed up on February 3rd, 2021. Okay? So that's when I signed up. And today's date is none other than February 12th. Okay? So if it's February 12th, in a matter of nine days? I mean, I not bad. Shit. Shit fuck, right? Pretty good. So, and let me show you how I'm doing this. So now we look at all time. When you go to all time, if you look at all time right now and you hit all time right now, what does that tell you? Tells you that I'm up 19 bucks, whatever, but this is just, again, this is looking in every natural resource, getting a couple dollars, couple here, and once this shit takes off, once society gets back out there, and once everyone starts spending their money, and once everything starts happening, then yeah, that's what happens. I mean, I'm just going to have a good time just making some money, because everyone's going to be out there spending their taxes, stimulus money, cosmetics, clothing, fashion. I mean, these fashion bars are really cool. Again, Christine Andrew, she has one of the first fashion bars, a successful fashion bar. So, I mean, again, I'm looking at every angle, everywhere possible. So we're going to get into the stocks now. And you guys got to see how much I'm investing again. All right. So here we go. I'm going to show you everything I'm investing in. All right. So first, AMC. AMC, I got 7 shares in that. Now, when I look at this, I'm going to just go ahead and show you that if you look at the total percentage change, all right? And that's what I pay attention to. What I recommend is when you get Robinhood, don't sit there and look at how much money you're making. Look at the percentages. Look at everything, how much equity you have in it. And there's these options are here. They tell you. All you have to do, it tells you how much equity, it tells you everything. It tells you the options is what's the last price that was listed, what's the equity, what's the total amount that you've got in this thing and what it's worth, what's the percentage change, the total gain, what's the total loss. So I can hit total, you know, loss right now and show you total loss for my 7 shares, my total loss for my 7 shares of AMC. I fucking love the movies. Of course I want to have a few shares in that. It cost me nothing, but my 7 shares right now, I'm at negative $21.50. Okay? I'm not gonna panic. You know why? Because I have 7 shares. So I've only lost 20 bucks. That tells me that once everybody gets out there, once the movies open up, once everything, the restaurants are already opening, then hey, we're gonna drive that stock price up. Okay, next thing that I'm in, Ideanomics. I like Ideanomics. IDEX. I like it. I mean, for me, I personally like Ideanomics. So I'll go ahead and show you. I got 6 shares into that. You guys can see. And I got it at $4. IDEX. I got it at, let's see, market buy was, got market buy at $25, and another $5, then $2. Okay. Nonetheless, I have almost 7 shares. Okay. I got almost 7 shares. Not bad. I like it. Again, we're going to look at how much money have, let's see, how much money have I lost? And we look at that. Nothing. I didn't lose anything. I got some cents. So if you look at the next two stocks, Volkswagen, cents. You look at the next one. Look, cents. See, I'm getting some money. So now we're, you guys see my strategy, right? I'm not in too deep. I'm going to put my money everywhere. Not going to throw all my fucking marbles in one bucket and be like, hey, I hope this works. And if it does, I'm a millionaire. No, I'm going to put my marbles in as many fucking buckets as there is possible. And if there's no more buckets, then I'll fucking start digging holes and making my own buckets. All right. So, again, let's go to the next one. Volkswagen. I got 4 shares. 4 shares in Volkswagen. Again, with everyone going with the deals, with all these, you know, all these great deals and trying to phase out these gas cars, then what happens? The price of the stock's gonna go up, and then once electric vehicles are here, the stock's price is gonna stay, and it's just gonna increase from there. Okay, so I got how many positions? 4 on the dot. Look, bam, baby, 4. All right, so not bad. Let's look at the next one. AVID, Avid Technology. I like it. I mean, I do. I got 3 shares in it. I mean, the market value right now is $70.99. All right. So we're going to go ahead and look. And when I got in this thing, I put in, I got a couple buys. I got one in at $21.18, one at $23, and I bought in again at $24. And see how the reason why I'm buying in like that is because I'm climbing that ladder. This is what I like to, this is fucking climbing Matt's ladder. I mean, shit, I don't need to do it at anyone else's speed. I'm gonna fucking climb this ladder the way I see. I gotta make sure it's safe first. I'm not gonna just be like, oh yeah, you made it up there, great. Now, I'm gonna fucking make sure that I'm not putting myself in any type of danger or risk. You know, and again, let me just rephrase that. When you invest and when you put in stocks, you are taking a risk. You absolutely fucking are taking a risk. But that's where, if you care enough to do your research and you see that, hey, you know what, and you talk to the right people and you start, you know, okay, all right, you know what, I see what's going on. So if you do that, that's smart investing. Now, again, my cap for $5,000, I could lose it all, and that's my cap. And then, again, if I see I'm down to a couple, $200, I'll sell out, and I lost $4,800. I'm cool with that. I mean, I'm not cool with it. I'll be pissed off, but at the end of the day, life goes on. I'm not going to sit there and beat a dead horse. So let's get back into the stocks. So next one. I get excited. Sorry, guys. I repeat myself a lot, but you know what? It is what it is, and it does what it does. All right, PLTR. I like it. I sure do like it. I own a total of 3 positions in that. Again, I'm climbing the ladder, and I'll show you what I mean by that. I got in PLTR, how many times? 2 times. One in at, look. So I climb the ladder, I watch. Now, the cool thing about this is you can create folders, and you can create, anyway, so I have my banks. Even though these ain't my banks, even though they aren't, you know, I don't even have an account there, but I own stock in them, so my bank New York, my bank California, my bank UK, my bank Canada. I'm getting stocks in everywhere, you know, and Egypt. Anything I can get in any bank, if the stock is low, it's worth, you know, especially it's really low. And with everything transitioning to cryptocurrency and with everybody following suit, with all these big banks following suit, I mean, hey, it's a matter of time before, you know, where I'm talking about in super advanced mode. I'm talking about beast mode. All right, so PLTR, I like it. Next one is going to be AACG. All right, now what that is, I have 1 share. Okay, and this 1 share right here is, I'll go ahead and read it to you. ATA Creativity Global engages in the provision of computer-based testing services. It services professional and certification tests in various industries, which include IT services, banking, teaching, and insurance. All right. And the company was founded by Walter Lynn Wang in 1999. I apologize about mispronunciation there. Next one. I like this one right here. Okay. Again, do your research on that. I like it. You don't have to, we don't got to get into it. I'm just going to, the ones I really like, we'll get into the other ones. Don't worry about it. Digital Ally. Digital Ally is DGLY. I like it. I got 5 shares in it. Digital Ally. I mean, it was cheap, right? And with everything going digital, I'm like, hey, looking at all digital stuff. And so when I see Digital Ally, to me, I'm like, hey, digital. I like where your mind's at. You already tell me that. You said it in the name. So it, for me, I tell you right now exactly how much I bought in that. I'll tell you right now. Show you right there. 2 different times. Climbing that ladder. $6.20, then $9. You know, again, climb, just baby steps. We're not here to get rich tomorrow. We're here for the long-term investment. Okay, we're here for that substantial growth over the next course of these years as we transition even further into digital assets. All right, so next one I really like is GM. Again, GM and Volkswagen, I like what GM did with the commercial and the Super Bowl about digital assets and how they showed you everything was just touch. It was cool. The car looked awesome. So for me, that itself, you know, to me, probably, I'd say with electric vehicles, it can easily get up to $100 a share in the next couple months easily, and it's at $53.52. I own 2 shares, so I got 2 shares and I got 2 positions. Now I climbed that ladder. I climbed that ladder, you know, by just watching them. Again, okay, this one's cool. I really like this one. With everything going to digital, I'm like, man, there's got to be like a bank. Like, is there like a reality trust or is there something? And I found this one called DLR. Now, this is just, again, research. I'm not sitting here saying, oh, go get everything that I'm in. And no, that's not what I'm saying. What I'm telling you is do your research. And I did my research. Right now, on this right now, I'm actually down $5. See, I'm down $5. And I own almost 2 positions. You know, I'm not there yet, but my goal is to get 2 positions there. But I'm down. See, I'm down $5. Now, what I have to understand is that if this thing crashes to the ground, I lost $139, and if I end up getting the 2 shares times 2, you have to be okay with that. But you have to also understand you have other investments. That's why I'm not putting my marbles in one bucket. I have other investments, so if they're doing well, they cover this, and guess what? I get to just sit there and just let it grow. See what it does. Do my data. I take screenshots. I pay attention to my stocks. It is a lot. It is a lot. But I mean, at the end of the day, once you put the work in, the hard work, then you could just sit back, maybe move a few, you know, as you as they're on probation, like I said in my last video, you know, if they're not doing well, fucking fire them. All right. So next one, we're gonna go ahead and get into Riot. Riot, I love. I mean, I love Riot. R-I-O-T. I fucking love Riot. So Riot right there, look, boom. It's right around, sitting around $50. All right, $49 and, okay, $49. We'll call it $49 even. All right, so when I bought in, I'll show you right here how many times. I bought in a total of 4 times. The first time I bought in was for $37. $37, I said, wait a minute, this thing's going up. Let me buy in again, right? Bought in again. Then I bought in again, then I bought in again. Now, here's the prices. I bought in for $37, then bought in for $50, then bought in for $10, and then bought in for $5.92. Again, I'm climbing the ladder. I'm watching this and paying attention. Now, I like it. There's the transactions I was just talking about. I like it. Me personally, I like it. Do your research on it, Riot. It's a blockchain. So with blockchains, I mean, the ultimate blockchain is Ethereum, right? Ethereum is the shit. Ethereum, you can buy and trade anything with Ethereum, Bitcoin, anything with Ethereum, right? So with Ethereum, cool, that's right. Now, what about the other, you know, blockchains that are mining units for cryptocurrency? What about all those ones? Okay, so what are good ones out there? Now, I'm not saying Riot's a good one. I'm just telling you, I feel good about Riot. I like it. I mean, it's just me. It's a feeling. Again, this is just not everything that I'm doing is going to be for you. And you may not like it, and that's fine. We can agree to disagree. So, next one. We're going to go ahead and go to BYD. I think I told you guys about this last one. Board gaming. I like it. I own one share in there. A little over a share. Okay. All right. We're almost done here, guys. Just a couple more. Okay. This one I really like. Can. All right. So, Canon, look, listen to this. I really like this. This one right here, I don't know why, because I did my research on it, of course. But, again, that's another thing. When anybody's on Robinhood, and I know I bounce around here, but I promise I'll do my best to stay on course. When you're on Robinhood and you see stocks that are recommended and you see, oh, this stock is soaring, don't fucking listen to that. That's you listening to what people are talking about. Do your own research on it. So when I see that, I'm like, yeah, fuck that. That's what they want me to see that. You think Robinhood's here to help you out? Robinhood is not here to help you out. You have to help yourself out. You think when you wake up in the morning, you know, you have someone that's going to be like, come on, you have to go to work. You have to go. You're a grown-ass fucking man. You are a grown-ass woman. You better get your fucking ass up and get to work. So, you know, at the end of the day, you have to do your research. You have to, you know, pay attention. Don't just listen to what people are telling you. Don't just, oh, I'm being influenced by this. Or, hey, people are going to laugh at you. When you start doing this and you start talking about this, people are going to laugh at you. Friends, family, everyone's going to laugh at you. But you know what? It doesn't matter. Use that as motivation. Use that as, you know what? All right, cool. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and use this as motivation. I'm going to work even harder. And it's, and again, if it's whatever reason it is, if it's the proven right, the proven wrong, if it's whatever it is, if it's just so that you can do it, if it's just an investment, if it's just, hey, I'm inexperienced, whatever your reasoning is. So I like Can, right? Can is cool. Now let me go ahead and read Can to you. I own 5 shares in Can. Let me read this. All right, this is cool. I'll read it to you because I like this. So Canon Incorporated provides high performance computing solutions to efficiently solve complex problems. Currently, the company is focused on the research and development of advanced technology, including such areas as AL chips, AL algorithms, AL architectures, system on a chip, SOC, right? So as we keep reading this, you see that it's using the AL chip as its base. Canon has established an intellectual value chain. So the company also provides a suit. I'm buying more on this. As I keep fucking reading this and I see that it's been going up, I mean, look, I show you right now. I bought in at 10, all right? And I was like, fuck it, I want more. February 9th, made my account on the 3rd, found this by the 9th, you know, I was like, yeah, I'm buying in, bought in. Hey, right now I own, you know, let's see, total less than 5.5 shares. You know, that's fine, 5 shares is cool, but I'm already up. I'm cool with that. I like it. Hey, artificial intelligence? Yes, please, which goes to my next topic, okay? All right, Global X Funds, Global X Artificial Intelligence, and I would have gave you the last after end, but I don't see what the fuck it is, so. All right, so, okay, AIQ tracks a market cap weight index of development market equities involved in artificial intelligence and big data. The listed name for AIQ is Global X Funds Global X Artificial Intelligence and Technology ETF. So what do you think Tesla's doing? Tesla's ahead of the game. So they're going to be hovering, you know, that car I told you, that Roadster, fucking hovering over the floor, you know, picking people up. With services, I know it's scary. I know people get scared, but you know what? Digital assets have been happening and they're increasing. And when everyone was on lockdown on pandemic, that was the most digital assets in US history that occurred. All those transactions through space, all digital currency, right? The most bond exchanges, right? I mean, that's another one. We had the most bond exchanges the last couple of years than we've ever had. And you want to see the increase Why is it the all these companies take an expensive haircut? You know, they're you know, they do it, you know, a bond exchange, now they lose half the fucking debt. Now you gotta fucking do your research and pay attention. So I like AIQ. I like it. All right, bots. This goes hand in hand with you know, with A. With, look, see how I did CAN, AIQ, and bots. I did them together because they're all artificial intelligence. So BOTZ. BOTZ, $36.32. Why not? I mean, shit. So I got myself a total of, I'll tell you right now, I got one share, a little over a share. But you know what? I'm going more. I want more. I like this one. Again, as I talk to you guys, sometimes I read stuff and I'm like, man, market value $47.39. Right now I got, it's $36. I look at the position. I see the today's return, total return. I look at the percentage increase. I like it. So again, I'll fucking buy in at a dollar. I mean, not a dollar, but I'll buy in like at $5, $6 and watch something and just see the increase. Just do my research on it to where I'm not, you know, I got my marbles spread around through so many resources, right? A very diverse portfolio. But again, it whatever works for you. Okay. Ebon, E-B-O-N. I love it. I fucking love it. There it is right there. Ebang. I love it. E-B-O-N. I own a total of 16 shares in that. So you can see right there. I love it. 16 shares. Let me tell you about Ebon. E-B-O-N. Okay. I bought in at $60. And I got, you know, a good amount of shares. Then I bought in again at $36. That was me climbing my ladder. Again, I'll show you. So, as I'm climbing that ladder, let me tell you right now about Ebon. eBay International Holdings Incorporated is a blockchain technology company. What? A blockchain technology company? Wait, isn't that like Riot? Yeah, it is, and I like them both. So, it's a blockchain technology company. It engages in the research and development of ASIC chip technology used in blockchain applications in China. Where does most of our fucking shit come from? China. The company also manufactures Bitcoin mining machines. So do your research. It's actually pretty cool. I've seen it, and this is what got me excited. They actually have a Bitcoin machine here in fucking Fontana, California. I don't live in Fontana, California, but I've been around the area, and they fucking have a machine. It's a yellow Bitcoin machine right next to an ATM. So if they're manufacturing in these machines, and as the increase for cryptocurrency and Ethereum and everything goes up, I mean, what does that tell you? Hey, the demand for this is going to be up. That means we're going to have to hire some more people to make these things. So, hey, the stock's going to go up, right? I mean, this is, again, this is my vision, how I see it, how what I believe. You may be like, you sound like an idiot, and I'm dumb now, and fuck you. And I'm okay with that. I mean, it's good. So, 16 shares I own in that. I like it. I mean, I'm telling you, I like it. I really do. So, these ones that I'm kind of showing you more of, I really do like. Okay, this one right here, again, right under, again, I like it. Centennial Resource Development, CDEV. I like CDEV. I really do like CDEV, and I'll tell you why. Centennial Resource Development Incorporated operates as an oil and natural gas company. It focuses on the development of unconventional oil and liquids, rich natural gas reserves in the Permian basin. The company was founded in October 2014 and is headquartered in Denver, Colorado. Listed name for CDEV is Centennial Resource Development Class A Common Stock. I like it. I mean, I bought in at $20. And I was like, wait a minute, I like the way the CDEV is going. I started reading some more information. And again, I always look at, hey, if you're going to get three cookies from three different people, well, hey, they all look good, but what's in it? Like, what's the ingredient? Like, is it going to last? What if I want the whole cookie right now? What if I want to save it for later? Is it going to be all stale and nasty? So you have to look at it like that, right? I mean, this fucking thing works weird. So, as I did, I say, let me get six shares. There you go. I mean, this is just a feeling. I like it. I mean, this is just I mean, not everything is going to be for you. Okay, PLL, I like. Piedmont Lithium, I love it. Because Piedmont Lithium sells the SC6, which is PLL. PLL, yeah. It gets me excited. PLL is good. Really, really good. Alexa, play. I mean, PLL is really, really, really good. I mean, really, really good. I mean, PLL is really, really good. We'll save that for later. But, all right, so PLL is really, really, really good. Okay, the next one I like is SNDL. Okay, this one is still good right now. Look at it. It's dropped. The price is good. I'll be okay if that price drops to a dollar. I'm good with that. So I don't know if everybody was looking. A lot on Robinhood apps, they're showing you like a canopy growth company. They were trying to do like a pump and dump. And I don't know, that to me, I don't like that pump and dump. So I went with Sundial Growers, SNDL. I like it a lot. Their stock is nice. Again, remember I told you guys about the bank, the CEO for Twitter, Square. So I like Square. Square is really good. I'm going to keep investing in Square. And hopefully over a period of time, I can get at least five positions. Currently, I own one position. So a little over one. I'm getting close to two. So I like Square. Square is a really, really good one. Let me go ahead and go to LAC. All right, Lithium Americas. I really like LAC. LAC is really, really good. Do your research on them. I mean, with the demand of lithium going up and electric vehicles, I like LAC a lot. LAC is a really good one. I just bought one stock of this Uber. I bought it this morning. I was debating between Uber and Lyft, but I ended up going with Uber. And the reason being is if this Roadster takes off and for Tesla and all these other vehicles as we transition even further in technology, if Uber can be the service and they can do like a merger with Tesla or something, and I mean, that would be huge. This stock could potentially rise to a couple $1,000. So I'm just going to sit on that. Even if this drops to $1, I still won't sell. I have to understand that I invested $60. So that means that I'm not selling out. I'm gonna watch that thing crash to a dollar and be like, all right, I'll sell out. Let me get that dollar, or let me get that 50 cents, or let me get that 20, as long as I'm going negative, right? So, you know, I already threw the money away. It's gone. That's the way I see it, right? But I own my share. So now we're going to go ahead and go to LTHM. All right. I want you guys to do your research on LTHM. Come back, comment. Leave a message about LTHM. I like it. I mean, me personally, I like LTHM. I got two shares in them. I really like them. I just bought a small. Like, I didn't think. I'll tell you right now how much I put in. I bought a very small into Apple. I put in $35. Right? Can you see it? Where is it at? Right there. Can't see it still. Fucks it out. There you go. $35. All right, I bought in $35. It's not much, but if that $35 goes down, then that, which it's not, with everything going up and like I said, everyone's got a lot of money to spend. They've been saving. I like Apple, so I'm gonna try to get one stock, and hopefully over the next 5-6 years, that one stock, you know, if I can get my one stock before it gets up to like 180, if I can get it, I mean, hopefully I have the potential to, you know, get 1,000 out of it. In the next 8 years. All right, so let's get into the cryptocurrencies real quick, because this video is taking a long time and shit. I mean, I know I can keep talking, but we'll get into the cryptocurrencies. I really like Ethereum Classic. Again, I keep talking about Ethereum Classic. Do your research on it, ETC Crypto. And what I really like on it is that they have ETC Crypto on Coinbase. So when you go to Coinbase and you have a Coinbase account through Bitcoin, you'll see that, wait a minute, how come they don't have Dogecoin on here? Well, because Dogecoin is not officially a cryptocurrency yet. It's just, hey, well, I mean, it is and it isn't. You're just trading at market value. That's how you get money out of it. But I mean, it's not like this. I mean, it's on there. So check it out. I would do your research on this. I mean, ETC, I currently own of Ethereum Classic. I own, let's see here. 17 shares. So I'll show you. As you go look, you can see. You see my Dogecoin. Dogecoin is 6,500, 6,598. I'm not putting no more money in Dogecoin. Like I said, I told you in my last video how to do it. If you just put, you know, $100 in it and just leave it alone and go look at it in 5 years, you know, you'll be surprised. But you just have to leave it alone and be okay with just losing $100, because a lot of people are going to be like, look at it and they'll see it get down to 60 and be like, no, I don't want no more. I lost $40, but you can't panic. Damn, shit. All right. Okay, so there it is right there, so you can see. I don't know if you can see that. All right. So I really like Ethereum Classic. Ethereum Classic is really, really, really good. I'm going to make another video. I'm going to keep making these videos and just try to make them for educational purposes and just spread the word and let everybody know that, hey, as digital assets are here, why not get involved? Why not invest? I mean, everything happens for a reason, right? Everything. I always believe that. And who knows? I mean, maybe we all can learn something along the way and help each other and learn something and not be left behind with technology, but rather be invested in it. So I'm going to leave you guys with this. Just have a wonderful day. You guys take care. And don't forget to walk by faith. Walk with faith.